was the second sonata from the Telemann six canonic sonatas for flute. It was originally written for recorder. I just played it on bass clarinet. You can play it on clarinet, saxophone, flute, oboe, kazoo, bass clarinet, doesn't matter. The range is right in the middle of the instrument, so just about anybody can play it. So I actually downloaded this for free from a terrific site called imslp.org. The link to this music is right here. That site has a ton of sheet music that you can download. That's most of it is in the public domain, so it's not illegal. So go ahead and check that site out. But download this, because we're going to be using this to talk about what's happening next in this video. So it is a canonic sonata. Well, do you know what a canon is? If you can remember when you were, I don't know, 2 or 3 years old, when you learned how to sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat, you would sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat gently down the stream, and then the person next to you would start singing Row, Row, Row Your Boat as you continued along, and they were always, you know, a couple of measures behind you. That is a canon. And a simple canon is what these Telemann canonic sonatas are. Everybody plays off of one sheet. The first person starts playing, the next person waits one measure, and then starts playing the same thing, and you're offset by one measure. You are delayed by one measure. So, if you want to do this without a second person, you're going to use the software that we're going to talk about in the rest of this video. Now, the program that I use is called Max MSP, or Max for short, M-A-X, and you can download a 30-day trial, free trial, of that software right here, and we're going to be using that to show you how you can do this with equipment that you probably already own. So cool. How did I do what you just heard? Well, I have my Mac computer. You can do this with a Mac or a PC. And I have my iPhone headphone cable here, which conveniently has a microphone right there. Because, you know, when you're talking on the phone, there's the microphone. You can use this microphone on your computer. Now, if you have a Samsung Galaxy or any other phone that you use where you have a headphone that you can talk into, you can use that. You don't have to have an iPhone. So what I did was I plugged that cable into the microphone port of my computer, and I used this software called Max, and basically, that's all you need. If you have a computer and that has a speaker in it and a headphone, you can do what I just did. Now, it's a little bit better if you have an external speaker that you can plug in like I just did, because then it's going to be a little bit louder. So the next thing I need you to do is download that Max MSP software. Here's a video that shows you how to do it.
So to get started, you're going to want to open up the browser of your choice and go to cycling74.com. Once you get there, you'll see this page, unless they've changed it. And you go to the upper right and click Download Max. You have your choice of the Mac OS X version or the Windows version. And notice over here on the left it says for new downloads, Max 8 is free for 30 days. So that means you have 30 days to play with it, after which it will stop working. So it's a free 30-day trial, completely unrestricted. So if you're not planning on starting this project right away, I would recommend you not open up Max, because that will start the clock running and then the 30 days will be gone sooner. But once that's over, you have a choice to buy Max. It comes with a monthly subscription, annual subscription. You can buy it outright as a permanent license. If you are a student or a teacher, you get discounts on all of that.
Okay, so now that you've downloaded Max and you've downloaded the sheet music, all you need now is to download the patch, which is the document file that Max makes, that I wrote to make this delay thing happen, okay? So once you have that patch, you have Max, and you have the music, and a computer, and a headphone cable, you are totally set to do what I just did, okay? But I would love for you to understand how it works and the basics of electronic music. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn this video off and I'm going to show you on my computer exactly what I did, how Max works, and it's a basic first tutorial about electronic music, because electronic music is my jam. Anybody who's ever seen me in a concert or met me knows that that's all I do. I use this program, Max MSP, for all of my concerts. And so I'm really excited about it. I don't work for the company. It's just something that I've used for like the last 25 years. I want to get you as excited about it as I am. So let's do that right now.
All right, so once you've downloaded Max and installed it, don't open it quite yet. First thing you're going to want to do is, if you're using the iPhone headphones like we talked about, plug those into your computer now. You're going to want to plug those in before you launch Max, because we want Max to be able to see that as an input device. We want it to see the microphone and see the headphones. So go ahead and plug those in and then open up Max. Once Max opens, you may see a welcome screen. If it's the first time you've opened it, you probably will. I don't, because it's not the first time I've opened it. Go ahead and click out of the welcome screen, and you're going to see the menu up here on the left, and I want you to go to Options, audio status. That's going to open up a window with a bunch of stuff you're not going to understand. That's totally fine. You don't need to understand it except for the input device and the output device we have to set. And we're going to set the input device to our external microphone. That is the microphone in our iPhone headphones, believe it or not. And then you have your choice. You can either have the headphones play the sound, which means that's the only way you're going to hear it is if you have external headphones, or you can have a choice of having it come out of your MacBook Pro speakers. Right now I'm going to put it on MacBook Pro speakers, and then I can close this window. And that is all you need to do to set up to get sound. Now I'd like you to come up to the File menu and choose New Patcher. That's going to open up a blank window, and I'll give you a quick guided tour of it. But first, I want to explain to you what Max is. Max is a computer program that allows you to create your own computer program, sort of, without having to know how to code. And the way the developers have done this is that they've created a bunch of these icons, which are called objects. Each one of them does a very specific thing. It performs a very specific function inside of Max. You do not need to know how it works. You just need to know how to use it. And that's what I'm going to show you today. So as a quick guided tour, these are the objects, and we're going to talk a little bit about those. Those are going to be the focus of this tutorial and the rest of them. On the right and left side are a bunch of menu icons. We do not need to know those because they're not part of this. And on the bottom, there are a bunch more, which you also don't need to know except for this bottom left, which is called lock. Now, the way that this program works is you do your editing when it's unlocked, and then you click it. Once it's locked, then you can use the program that you have created. So we're going to unlock and get started. There are a lot of ways you can use Max, but the easiest way for me to explain it is to think of it like a flowchart. Now, what is a flowchart? If you don't know, you can go look it up in Wikipedia. It's really simple, but all of us have seen them. You have an input at the top, and then you have to make some decisions which may split you. So, do I need to do this, or do I need to do that, or would I prefer this or prefer that, or a yes or no question, and that will split the process of your flow, and ultimately, at the very bottom, you get the answer you're looking for. Max kind of works the same way, and so I'm going to set it up vertically, where there's an input at the top and an output at the bottom. And as an example of this, let's just do a simple math problem. That'll allow us to use a couple of the objects that we're going to use in the rest of the tutorial. Let's say we would like to add 10 to a number. The input is, what is the number we need to add to? The calculation is plus 10, and our output is the result of whatever that number is, plus 10. Let's do the equivalent here in Max. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to need to get that number input. And up here in the middle is the box. It's got a little triangle icon. And I'm going to click that and drag it down to my window and release. And that's going to show me a box with a number in it. Currently is 0. Let me show you how this works. Like I said, you have to lock the patch in order to make it actually function. I'm going to come back up here to the 0, and I'm going to click and drag. If I click and drag up, the numbers go up. If I click and drag down, the numbers go down. And then when I release, it just sort of leaves the number. But it sends out that flow of numbers out of the outlet. Now, what is an outlet? If you come up close to the box, you'll see a bunch of circles that when you roll over them, there's a little message window that shows up that tells you what's happening out of that little circle. Now, this is an output because it's at the bottom, and it says it outputs the number. So we just need to have an input to add 10 to it, right? In order to do that, we're going to use a second object, and this is the object box. It's in the upper left, and this is probably, I'm going to click and drag and drop it, the most complicated because it's the closest you're going to get to code. It's an empty box with a flashing cursor, which looks really intimidating because you have no idea what it is. But all you have to do is know a couple of things to type into it, and all of a sudden, that object knows its purpose in life. Now, what did we say we want to do? We want to add 10, so I'm going to type plus space 10 and hit return. And I'm just going to drag this out so we can see it. Now, this object knows its purpose in life is to add 10 to whatever comes in the inlet. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on that inlet and drag it up to the number box. Now, if we look at our math problem, it's 16 plus 10. Now, the only thing we have left to do is to get the output. So I'm going to take another number box, drag it down to the bottom, and I'm going to take the output, click, drag, and release, and now I have a full math equation. Let's take a look. So let me lock the patch so that we can use it, and when I click and drag, oh my god, this is magic. 46 plus 10 is 56. Okay, so this performs as we expect. 43 plus 10 is 53.
But let's not stop there. I'm going to unlock the patch. I'm going to drag this 43 box over to the middle. And I'd like to do another equation, different math equation to it. So I'm going to grab another object box, and let's multiply 43 by 6. Wow. Here's another object box, and it's waiting for us to give it its purpose in life. Now, multiplication and division, this is one thing you need to know about coding. You don't use the X and the division sign. The X for multiplication, you use the star key, which is above the 8 key. And for division, you use the slash key, which is underneath the question mark. Okay? So we're going to multiply by 6. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Shift 8, which gives me the star space 6. Hit return, and we have another box. Let me just pull out my number box for my output and connect everything up. So, once I lock it, we're going to see two equations happen at once. 44 plus 10 is 54. 44 times 6 is 264. This shows you the basics of how the flow works. Now we're going to get started with actually doing something with sound. Now, I've opened up a brand new patcher window using the file new patcher. Now, you'll recall we've used that object icon, we've used the number icon, and over here is a plus. What is the plus? It's more icons. There's basic and audio and data and so forth. We want audio. Let's take a look at these icons here. These should look somewhat familiar. That is a microphone. We'll need one of those to get sound in. Over next to it is a speaker. I'll buy one of those and we'll put that at the bottom. And again, I'm going to use this like a flowchart from top to the bottom. We're going to have sound coming in. We're going to do some stuff to that sound here, and we'll have sound coming out our speaker. Next on the right is gain. Gain is another word for a volume knob. And instead of it being a knob, this is a vertical slider. Up is loud, down is soft. And that should be enough for our basic audio input and output. Okay, so again, if you'll recall, there is an outlet, and here it says signal audio. That's the audio coming out of our microphone. We want to plug that into the volume knob or the volume slider, which is called gain. And outside of the gain, we're going to connect that to the speakers. I'm going to lock our patch, and simply put, I'm going to click the microphone. It will turn on. I'm going to turn up the volume a little bit. And all of a sudden, you've got me coming through your max patch. But how do you know? How do you know that's really happening? Let me turn it off. I'm going to unlock it. There's something you can use called a meter, an audio meter. You can have a digital looking one, or you can have an analog looking one. Let's take an analog looking one because that's kind of nice and retro. I'm going to take that and I'm going to plug that into the gain as well. And it's going to show me that sound is in fact coming through this flow. Now, I don't plug the volume directly into the speaker. I'm putting it over to the side because the volume is just something that reads the sound. It doesn't pass sound through. Just something for you to know. I'm going to lock it again. I'm going to click the microphone on. And when I talk, you see the level meter is moving. And if I turn it up, it's going to be louder. And if I turn it down, it's going to be softer. So that just shows you that we have sound coming into our microphone and out through our speaker. This is something useful for you to do at the very beginning just to make sure you have sound coming out. Now that we know that we have sound coming in, we can control it with some volume and sound coming out. We want to create a delay so that the sound that's coming out also comes out a few seconds later. So in order to do that, we're going to come back up here to our icons. I'm going to pull an object box out. I'm going to drop it over here, and I'm going to type T-A-P-I-N, tap in, tilde. Tilde is the key that is to the left of your one key and above your tab key. And then I'm going to set type space 1000. I'm going to hit return. I'm going to take another object box, drag it down here, and type T-A-P-O-U-T, tap out, tilde. Space 1000 and hit return again. And I'm going to connect the two of these together with a patch cable. All right, so what is this here? Tap in and tap out as a unit, it creates a delay of however many milliseconds, that's 1/1000th of a second,
that is listed here and here. Now, 1,000 milliseconds equals what? 1 second. So what is going to happen is this tap-in is expecting some audio. It's going to hold on to its second, and it's going to spit it out, tap out 1 second later. So what we need to do is we need to connect our audio to tap-in, and we're going to take the output of tap-out and bring it back over here to our volume gain control. Okay? So again, just to look at the flowchart, we have sound coming in straight out. And then we have sound coming in, and it's going to hold on to that audio for 1 second and then spit it out. So you will hear me say something, and then you will hear me say something 1 second later. I'm going to lock this patch, and once I turn this on, I'm going to talk. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Great. Let me turn this off. Let me turn this off. Unlock and change this 1,000. I'm going to double click inside here. It's going to grab everything. So I just want that 1,000. If I turn it to 2,000 and I change this one to 2,000 and lock it, what do you think is going to happen? What do you think is going to happen? What do you think is going to happen? It waited 2 seconds. So simply put, anything that comes through a second time, however many milliseconds later. And that's basically how I made the Telemon work. So now I'm going to open up the Telemon delay patch. This is the patch that you downloaded a minute ago. And I'm going to take you on a quick guided tour. Now, there are going to be a bunch of objects in here that you don't recognize, and that's totally cool. But there are a couple that you will. Up here is the microphone. Down here is the speaker. Here is the gain volume control. Here is our tap in and tap out. That's our delay. And the rest of this stuff is simply a way to do the math to tell the delay how long you want it to delay. 60 beats per minute means each beat is 1 second, right? Because there's 60 seconds in a minute. 60 beats per minute is 1 second each. Now, if we want to have it delay 4 beats, we have to do a little multiplication like we did a long time ago. So 4 times 1,000 is 4,000, and that's delaying our tap, our delay, for 4,000 milliseconds. If I want to make this 120 beats per minute, that's 500 milliseconds per 1 beat times 4. 500 times 4 is 2,000, and that means our delay is 2,000. So that's all you really need to know. And all, of course, there are a bunch of instructions over here. If I turn this on, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I've got my delay. So that's all you need in order to make this work. One last thing. Over here is a metronome. This is useful in, just in case you need to play the metronome while you're playing with yourself so you can stay in time. You do not have to use this. I'll turn this on and then I'll turn the metronome so you can hear it. If I make the metronome slower, let's say 93 beats per minute. The fastest metronome that you'll ever find. That's 343 beats per minute. Okay, so that metronome is just so that you can figure out how to play in time with yourself. You know, once you've practiced it for a while, you might not need to use it. Okay, so back to you, Michael.
All right, so with that basic primer on how Max works, how electronic music works, and how we made that delay, I would like for you to take those three things, the patch, the sheet music, and Max, and I want you to try it yourself using this equipment. Just to show yourself that you can, okay? So, and if you do, I would love for you to record it and put a link to your video in the comment section below so we can all watch it. And we're gonna be doing more electronic music next time and probably for a couple of videos for the rest of this season, because this is something that I'm really obviously passionate about and I would love to share with you. So until the next time, have fun. Write if you have any questions, you know how to reach me, and I will see you next time.